Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. In this DC-to-DC converter part 2 lecture, we go deeper into the topic of DC-DC converters, where we focus on the boost and buck and boost converters. The main learning objectives will fall under two questions. First, how does a boost converter work? Second, what is the working principle of a combination of the buck and boost converters? The step-up or the boost converters are widely employed to increase the level of the input DC voltage. For example, when you drive the electric car, the battery provides the power to the motor for propelling the car. In this case, the bidirectional battery converter is working in a boost mode, which is to convert the power with the low battery voltage into the power with the higher voltage on the high voltage bus. Under this mode, the battery on the left side is the input voltage Vin, and the high voltage bus on the right side is the output voltage V out. The DC to DC conversion is conducted typically through a switch and a diode. Note that due to the placement of the diode at the output, the flow of the current from output to input is not possible for a boost converter. The output voltage of a boost converter is calculated by the input voltage divided by 1 minus the duty cycle of the switch. This can be proved by a simple equation. Transferring power to higher output voltage levels is possible in the boost converters as the energy stored in the inductor by the input voltage source increases during the on-time period. During the on state of the switch, the voltage across the inductor is equal to the input voltage that is shown by the green area, and the inductor current linearly increases. The capacitor supplies the load, and therefore the output voltage starts to decrease. Then the energy stored in the inductor is provided to the output during the off time of the switch when the voltage across the inductor is negative, as shown by the red area. During this period, the capacitor is charged where the output voltage increases. During the on time period, the inductor current derivative depends on the input voltage, while during the off time period, the derivative depends on the difference of the input and the output voltage. How can we make a DC to DC converter topology which would be able to step up and step down the voltage? We can combine the previous two topologies, namely the buck converter and the boost converter. When we flip the boost converter and combine these two converters, we create the buck and boost topology. In practice, the inductor is never ideal, so there's always some ohmic losses too. So a resistor is in series with the inductor. Then the topology of the buck and boost converter is redrawn into this topology. The output voltage is in this case battery voltage, and we assume constant input voltage too. This consists of two switches, which are equipped with the two antiparallel diodes. This combination is not so straightforward, as this converter is a buck from the left to the right side and a boost from the right to the left. Let us have a look at the more details. Here we analyzed in detail the operation of the buck and boost converter. This converter should be able to transfer power from the higher voltage V in to the lower voltage V not, and also vice versa. As it can be seen, the two switches S1 and S2 are connected across a DC voltage source Vin. Here, each switch consists of an IGBT with an antiparallel diode. The switches open and close alternatively in such a way that when the S1 is closed, S2 is open, and vice versa. Note that in this topology, both switches 1 and 2 cannot be closed at the same time, since the input will be short-circuited. The time of one cycle is T, and the S1 is closed for a period T on. It follows that the duty cycle of S1 is the D equal to T on divided by T, while that of S2 is 1 minus D. Let us analyze the boost operation. If S2 is conducting, the energy is stored in the inductor. When S2 is off, the diode of S1 takes the current over and delivers energy to the higher voltage level Vin. The buck operation is when the switch S1 is conducting. When S1 is off, the freewheeling diode of S2 takes the current over. By varying duty cycle D from 0 to 1, we can vary the current direction and whether it is buck or boost operation. The average current can flow in either direction depending on the magnitude of average voltage across terminals 1 and 2, V12, and the output voltage V0. Whether the converter is working on the buck mode or boost mode can be determined by comparing the duty cycle to the ratio between the input voltage Vin and the output battery voltage V0, as it is summarized in the table. The polarity of the DC voltage V0 remains fixed and current is changing the direction. It is hence a two-quadrant converter. Now we map the buck and boost converter back to the bidirectional battery converter of the electrical vehicle. When the regeneration power flows from the motor to the battery through the high voltage bus, the converter works as buck mode. It happens when DS1 creates average voltage on terminals 1 and 2 larger than battery voltage. On the other side, this converter works in the boost mode when the battery is powering the motor. It happens when DS1 creates average voltage on terminals 1 and 2 smaller than battery voltage. And remember, the duty cycle of switch S2 is always equal to 1 minus the duty cycle of S1. In reality, the battery converter is much more complex. If isolation is needed between the input and output, a dual active bridge converter with a high frequency transformer can be used. To wrap up, boost or step up converters have one switch and can help in boosting the voltage from a lower input to a higher output voltage, and to obtain bidirectional power flow, a buck and boost converter can be created by combining buck and boost converters. The buck and boost converter can operate in two quadrants by changing the direction of the current. Several other DC to DC power converter topologies are possible that can facilitate four-quadrant operation and provide isolation as the requirements may be.